Ja, yeah, Smart Wargames hier. Let's check out Gary Grigsby's War Between the States. That is a game you can acquire on the Slytherin Matrix store. And thanks to your support, the channel has nice income recently and acquired for you War in the States. It is currently also on a sale. Original price is high. But I already checked out the game. And it is offering a unique take on strategic US Civil War. Yeah, we have other choices like the quite popular HOD US Civil War 2, the new one, Grand Tactician. But this here has quite a different approach in some aspects, and I think it's still worth to check it out, especially for a sale price. Yeah, for installation, it works on modern systems quite good. Download, purchase it, download it, make sure that you get the newest patch. When it comes to modding, there is some modding done to leaders, scenarios. Make sure that you hit all topics, as some of those topics are older than 1 year and might not show up. Once you're in a folder, you can launch a game. There is a tutorial included, a video tutorial. And yeah, with gameplay, we need to keep it low a bit with the gameplay. It is a quite complex game. It's not that complex like War in the Pacific or War in the East, 1 and 2. But it's still hard if you want to make a review video. Gameplay, if you really do it serious, might take you some time. Yeah, tutorial. This game has one of the best video tutorial series I have seen so far, explaining very well all those aspects. You can enter them by hitting display check. Excel. However, this tool is, I had sometimes issues with it, that
when you begin a scenario of war between the states, you will begin
that the video is not playing. And no problem, head into the dead folder, video, and whatever I use, VLC media player, you can play those videos.
Although not as
and quickly check them out.
Adjusting there are some named forces.
They are also named Tutorial 1 to whatever, 18. And they give you a really good introduction into all those mechanics. Very well made. Really good tutorial videos. They should upload those things on YouTube. Would definitely help to popularize the game because I didn't hear that much about it. Other than that, manual, we can check it out. It is 184 pages plus some rule correction, as you saw there. Yeah, there's an ebook version with good navigation. You saw it here. Quite a lot of text, but I think the video series might help out a lot. And if you need more in-depth detail, you can then check out the manual. It's not really required to read the entire thing in order to operate the game. At least from a beginner perspective. Good. Other than that, you can launch the game. I'm running here newest Windows, and in contrary to War in the Pacific. No, that was wrong. This is the exe. In contrary to War in the Pacific, this game runs fine. Yeah, you sometimes have this issue that you don't see the infos, simply skip them by pressing space. Then you will hit the main menu. That is sometimes in many of those older games might have some, might be some codec issue that you don't see the videos. But that is not really important. If you want to see the info, it is in the video folder. And the game is running, contrary to War in the Pacific, pretty good in full screen. I spotted no issues so far. You can also run it windowed. It comes with some native resolution, not sure what it is, but it looks pretty okay. And I have not these issues from War in the Pacific. I need to run some third-party tools in order not to have some graphical glitches. You can also run with, I can show it during game, you can also run with counters. Normal game runs with sprites, they look pretty good. Scenarios, there's some guided, furthermore, there's some tutorial scenarios, we can quickly launch them. which come with text guidance. The soundtrack of this game is really good. There are some tracks that give you really the Gettysburg vibe. Yeah, okay, oh, we can exit now. I just want to show it to you, I don't want to go through it. Might be that we need to exit the game. Yeah, but you see it. You can run a tutorial, follow it in order to... I don't want to do that now. Yeah, and graphics, art style is very professional. Yeah, I guess because we quit the game in an unusual manner, we need to set the music back. Okay. Yes, and then we have different scenarios with different time frames. That is basically the grand campaign, Battle Cry of Freedom. You can play either Hot Seat or versus AI. And you also have the choice to leave the production to the AI. Or you can also do, I don't know if that might be interesting. You can even manually do production while everything else is done by the AI. Not sure if this really works, but why not? But I guess typical setting would be either this or automated production. However, production is not that over the top in this game. Like, I don't know, the Japanese R&D in War in the Pacific. And yeah, you can also play by email, difficulty levels, which I guess gives the AI some bonuses. Okay, let's go into the game. We will play as a Union. Yeah, map is looking pretty good. I like it. Also, Gary Grigsby games have really nice sprite art. But if you're not into sprites, you can also switch it for counters. Then it looks like this, if that is more your thing. American Civil War in school, yeah, it is mentioned, but I guess it is of course not that extensive like in the US, as obviously. Yeah, we will now switch back to the sprites, because I like them, and go through the interface and then I will explain you what makes this game special. And yeah, graphically I really like it. Interface also pretty good. This game is focusing a lot on leadership. Yeah, leadership is very important, as it was in the war. Yeah, it was a very leadership-centric war, and a good leader could decide between success and defeat. We have map. Yeah, detailed combat screen will give you information about what happened last turn in combat, a summary. Then you have military forces screen. This game comes with different web. Military forces, you have militia. The Union is starting in the beginning with a lot of militia units. Those units not really that good in combat, especially against line infantry or professional infantry. Currently we are very low on infantry. And you don't produce them, you train them. And you train the militia up to infantry level, and you also have the ability, depending on different aspects, to train foot mobiles to untrained mounted infantry and then to cav. Especially in the beginning, it is really hard to get professional cav. There's also chance involved because it requires good horses, etc. Later in the war, it might become easier. Good, next we have some further data screens, which give you basically the more information. And leaders. Yeah, leaders is very important in this game. There's a lot of historical leaders in the And you can also activate a subcommander mode. You have different stats of those leaders. There's leaders that are specifically combat commanders. Those guys you want to keep in frontline units. And there are commanders that are really good at logistics, which you might rather want to keep for higher command. Yeah, you have the way to appoint army commanders and even theater commanders. You are allowed to appoint 4 army commanders and up to 2 theater commanders. Typically, you do east and west. Those guys can provide initiative bonuses, which is very important, especially for the Union player, in order to be able to maneuver and attack. And you might be required to have good leaders there, but you need also to keep them close to the front lines in order to execute this bonus, which also might put them in danger of getting killed. So leadership is a really big thing. There's a lot of management going on with leadership. You can promote them, it might cost you political points. You can appoint them, you can dismiss them. And you can also play with an optional rule that leadership bonus is, or some leadership values are hidden from you. You first need to find out about them, and leaders might also get auto-promoted by combat performance. Yeah, production is a separate phase in this game. There's basically a maneuver and combat phase, which we are currently in. And then there's a production phase. Yeah, first, exactly, movement phase and then production phase. It is state-based, and yeah, some states can only produce specific things at specific dates and then might be able to produce other things. Supply, then later they might be able to produce naval forces or factories in order to produce more, depending on your strategy. Yeah, if there is nothing you want to really go into it, you can automate it. You rather want to focus on maneuver and combat. Yeah, leaders can be brought to the map. We have currently 2 leader activation left. A lot of leaders are not on the map. You can then basically bring them. You can raise them, appoint them. And it depends how much you can do every movement turn. This time we are allowed to activate 2 leaders. Yeah, repair is repairing stuff, and there's a strategic map looking similar to War in the Pacific, where you can quickly identify assets on your map and click and get to this area. Region information, that is basically simply showing you what is in those different locations when it comes to resources, manpower, population. And infrastructure. And also partisan activity. A supply system is in this game. Supply is quite interesting. You're not supposed to manually move supply around. Supply is automated, and units use supplies for combat, for training units. But what you can do is create supply hubs or depots, yeah, supply depots in order to bring resources in there. And it is also depends on the infrastructure. They need roads then or rails in order to be transported to the front lines or to your units. And supply is also a very important target for the enemy or for you. Yeah, you can raid supply, for example, with CAF. Destroy or capture supplies in order to starve enemy armies or live off the land. Yeah, that is current leaders. We will talk about them once we hit our unit. Yeah, infrastructure has different filters for the map. You can change the map zoom to the normal map. Can replay last turn and then end the turn. If you pick a unit, you might be presented with a screen that looks quite convoluted, but is quite informative and interesting. You have different leaders. this dark blue ribbon leaders are army commanders, which roll for initiative, but first for initiative rolls the theater commander. That is this light blue. You can only have two of them. And you should also check if those guys are good. Yeah, he has, for example, Scott has administration 4 if you check out the tooltip. That is good. You shouldn't appoint somebody with a high attack value or high defense value, but low administration value to become a theater commander. And you shouldn't also waste combat commanders on army command. Those guys are better meant for the front lines. Yeah, for example, you look for attack commander. Yeah, most of them have 2, but they might gain. Yeah. So it would be rather good if you keep guys with attack 2 around. Or if you're on defending, it might be great if you keep somebody with a high defense value, like here, Mansfield. Then you have other values like here, ETR, CTR, that is infantry training and cavalry training. And you can, every leader can carry up to 4 units. For example, Banks is a unit commander, yeah, and if you want to appoint him a unit like here, 7th Militia. Yeah, exactly, it worked out. Yeah, it was here. Banks now received a unit, but you can also, for example, you want for some reason add Arty into his command, you can do that. You can also remove them again. That might be important if you want to train units. Units that are attached to a leader will train with this leader. No doubt, if doesn't matter if he's good or bad at training. Units that are not attached to leadership will train with the best available commander that has enough command points. Yeah? So a guy that just moved out or just arrived might be not able to train. But if, for example, they're idling, they might pick here, I don't know, who is the best trainer here. For example, McCall has infantry training 3. He's the best instructor. He will train, for example, militia units and try to make professional infantry out of them. That is especially important for the Union player in the beginning, as as he can train them. That is, a Union player has in the beginning a lot of militia. You need to train them to become proper infantry, and then you might have more combat punch. But the downside of this is those units are not ready to maneuver. They have sometimes movement points, but they normally not that efficient at maneuvering, or they need leadership. Yeah? So if you want to move, for example, the 7th, attach them to a leader like Banks. And the 5th you can also attach. See, there's different capabilities. Some units run 6. And you can attach here on the screen as you see fit. Ah, damn it. Okay. That was. Watch out with the left mouse button. Move by accident the entire army into the ship. Okay, what happens? But you can undo it, I guess. Or not. Whatever. Right click in order to dismiss a menu. Good, yeah, there's naval combat, which is you can use RT or ships in order to blockade ports. You need to watch out if maneuvering ships along the coast, if there's heavy RT, they might reaction fire on you and might sink or damage your ships. Yeah, the scrolling is very slow. I might need to set it up. That is a bit too much. Or too slow. Is that really faster? Good. Yeah, and combat. So it is important to have theater commanders, army commanders. Usually you have army commanders very close to the front line or even at the front lines. And you have theater commanders. The tutorial mentions here there's two obvious picks, including Washington, for example, for the Western Front. Amphibious assaults are possible. And yeah, that is currently in maneuver phase. I can show you some combat. It is something, it is not a combat you should pick, but in order to show you the how combat looks like, yeah, we can, for example, with shift move an entire stack. You can also press here the button that is basically the order bar. Here you can appoint army commanders or theater commanders and also dismiss them. You, for example, don't agree with Scott as theater commander, you can dismiss him and appoint somebody else. And yeah, you can convert units. For example, we are currently allowed to convert this turn two militia to mounted units. So if you want to train up some calf, you could pick two militia units and start training them to become mounted. This will cost us supplies. If you don't have those supplies, it might not happen. It is a costly and a time-consuming affair, especially in the beginning. Okay, let's simply move a stack into that, but that is a suicidal battle. I really like how the movement looks like, this fluid. Yeah, you shouldn't move as individual units. You should put them under a proper command and then do it. This battle will be lost, but just in order to show you how it looks like. In every area you also have different options. For example, if you move with calf into an enemy area, I can't show you a tooltip, but you might be allowed to scout. Just because you're sitting on the same in the same zone doesn't mean combat has to happen. You can also scout, raid for supplies or raid infrastructure. And if you are in the situation that you can do an overrun attack, you might do that. That is here not the case, because the Confederates might win this battle easily. Can also bring more forces in, there's nothing else I can bring in. Those guys might come in, make it a bit more even, but this will be a lost battle. But we can, for example, do a raid, in order to show you that. I have here some calf. But it is, let's find something enemy. Here, for example. Because you sometimes need to find out about the enemy. Yeah, the score speed, you can set it, I guess. You need to raise it a ton in order to have a faster scrolling. Yeah, we don't really have calf units here, there's leadership. Increased time, I guess it is slowing down. I guess so. Okay, yeah, that is getting better. Yeah, that is now hitting my sweet spot. Okay, that is a bit too fast now. Yeah, interesting setting. I don't know why is it So, perhaps it has something to do with modern systems or with the resolution that is running in the background. But yeah, you will find a sweet spot somewhere. Can you enter? You can also enter this exact value, it seems. So you will find some value that is fine. And the delay can also be removed. Okay, whatever. But that is something you can figure out on your own. Yeah, here will now a combat happen. But first we will exit the production phase. Currently we are building a lot of supplies, training some RT, and a lot of militia was formed up, which requires training by leadership, which you can do in the rear or near the front lines as you see fit. But if those guys are of course engaged or raided, then those guys might be of course overrun and killed because they simply lack the training. They're basically militia. Let me read the chat. We did one topic a week in the semester. Every year get a week on slavery, 2 weeks on war, and then a week in the next class on reconstruction. But it was always the same material every year for year, always structured the same way. It's cool in the US's word, I guess. Don't like the sprites like NATO better, much less okay. Smart SGS Hawaii just came out on Steam and currently is 10% off. Yeah, I know, I have a video on that. And posted even a review there. Try NATO symbols. Didn't you see it? I showcased them. Yeah, sure, I can activate them again. Yeah, combat screen is a bit bare bone. I'm a big fan of this very detailed combat reports of war in the Pacific. Here it is basically a bar you're watching. That, I don't know if there's a setting, but that is a bit of a letdown. I think the combat resolution could be more detailed. I mean, in the end, it is a calculation. And I know as a lot of War Pacific players, they simply skip battle calculation as it takes them too long. I always like to see those single airplanes engaging each other. Good, we are falling back as we predicted, as this is a battle you don't want to take. And yeah, but casualties seem to be quite even, at least when it comes to destruction. But I guess a lot of those units lost further values. Yeah, I really like the movement, this fluid thing that is looking quite different from other games. Nice to see the AI running around here. And there's one track in the soundtrack, I can't bring it up, but that really gave me the Gettysburg vibes. But there's also some classic tunes or historical tunes, giving you a nice immersion. Yeah, sound design, everything is pretty good. If the Smart Wargame streams got you hooked like it did me, yeah, great that you enjoy them. Good to have you around. Yeah, we can do an entire turn with... I won't do that much because I don't want to prolong the video. I really recommend watch this tutorial series in case you get the game, but it should give you an idea how it will work. It is a lot about leadership, forming up armies, units, training them properly. And you always need to make sure that you have enough supplies, as otherwise you might risk running out of supplies in enemy territory. Yeah, some leaders can get ill. Okay, you wanted to see again the counters. Good. Yeah, also nice. Yeah, I mean, like, we can take a look how they move around. Is there anything I didn't explain? Yeah, naval combat. Yes. I think I already mentioned it. It's basically you as a Union player want, of course, to seal them off. And as a Confederate player, you want to keep those ports open. Probably use heavy arty to keep those ports and lanes open. This game considers those rivers here as indeed access points. For example, here, if you sit in this area, yeah, here that is, I guess, a good area. Those ports might be, they might be blockaded. You can also blockade a port by pulling arty close by. I need to quickly attend something. Yeah, I will do quickly a turn, and you can see how those counters move around. Let's skip production phase, and Jimmy, I need to. Okay, here. Yeah, okay, sorry, I need to do a phone call and cut the video short. But I think we already gave you an impression. Sure, it would be great to see somebody proficient play a couple of turns. Not proficient in this game. Visually, really like it. Also like the counter graphics. Both is great, whatever floats your boat. And it is basically a middle complexity game. Leadership is important, and I think that's quite suited for PBM or multiplayer play. As a hot seat, if you want to play some Civil War strategic game on Christmas or whatever, I think that's not a game where you will bog. Sure, you can, of course, take your time for every single decision, but it's not a game that will bog you down, I don't know, like War in the Pacific, where you might require for turn one several hours. Like, once you have everything set up, decide for a strategy. And that's perhaps also why combat is more abstracted, in order to be more accessible, more fast-paced, because that game was released close to the other game I will check out tonight, World at War. Those two games are a bit more or less complex. I guess then, I don't know, Gary Grigsby Studio or whatever had a phase where they wanted to do a bit more accessible games, but without being absolutely casual. Before they then returned with War in the East, which again is rather a very complex, in detail war game. So yeah, check it out. A thing on sale for Civil War fans. How it compares to American Civil War 2 by HOD. That is, of course, a matter of taste. I think war games are a matter of taste. There's no better or worse in a universal matter. But it, what might be important for you, it runs pretty good on modern systems. Good. Okay, I will quickly do the phone call and then I will come back with the other game, World at War. Seems to be some low or mid-complexity World War II global game, strategic or, yeah. But they should re-upload, I don't know if somebody's in contact with Slytherin, they should upload those tutorial videos. I think they are 10 times better, better multipliers than my video here. They will show you pretty good, because they're well made, not often seen such good tutorial videos.